So I just got back from probably one of the best weekends that I've ever had in my life. It was my bachelor party in Vegas, and it was with me and two of my best friends. And we did pretty much everything you could think of in Vegas and had the greatest time there. So we started off just going to the casinos. We won thousands of dollars each. We went to the Rip Club. You can probably guess what that is. I climbed up a 20-foot pole twice and had to grab my friend's belt. We also went to a pool party where I got sprayed down by six bottles of champagne. And then we went to a nightclub, Omnia, to shut down the club. We stayed there for about 5 hours, got a table, and just shut it down there. So overall, one of the best weekends I've ever had. Nothing went wrong other than one thing. And that is I ended up getting COVID right at the end of the trip. So I was there from Thursday to Sunday. Vegas is a super populated place, as you probably know. And I started to feel sick on Sunday when I woke up and we were heading home. So I thought I was just super hungover. I had major headaches and body aches, and I couldn't think at all. And it was basically just zombie trotting through the airport and getting on my plane and flying home. But I knew something was wrong when I got home. I knew I was getting sick. I didn't know what it was from. I was hoping it wasn't COVID, but it ended up being that. So I just want to walk you through what it was like getting COVID. It knocked me off my feet for about 4 days where I couldn't do any work at all. And I want to share with you how it affected me as an entrepreneur and how it affected my life and my business and what I was able to do on a day-to-day basis. So to address the elephant in the room, because I know some of you are probably wondering, no, I'm not vaccinated and I wasn't vaccinated. And I'm not pro or anti-vax. I just believe that we push this out pretty quickly, and I didn't want to just jump into injecting myself with something that's been around for less than a year. So I know that vaccines usually take about 7 to 8 years to be fully proven and fully accepted, and this has been around for less than a year. So I read on some of the side effects. I didn't want to jump straight into this, and I didn't get it. That's the reason I didn't get it. So I'm not pro or anti. I know some of you are going to get really butthurt about me not being vaccinated. That's totally fine. That's your opinion. But my decision was to hold off on getting vaccinated, and maybe I would never get it. But now I have COVID, and now I guess you could say that I'm naturally vaccinated because I have a much less chance of getting a reinfected because I already have it now. So with that out of the way, now that I covered that and fessed up to that, let's talk about what it's been like on a day-to-day basis and what was my experience getting COVID and what it felt like to me. So if we go back to Sunday, I was feeling pretty crappy. I had body aches, I had headache, I had a very light cough. And I didn't really think too much of it because I just thought I was extremely hungover. So I've had bachelor parties and just party weekends where I got hungover and I felt exactly the same. And it would last, for a few days sometimes. So I didn't think much of it. And I went home and just pretty much acted as normal. I went to sleep a little earlier. But Tuesday or Monday, I woke up and it felt worse. So my body aches were worse, my headache was worse. My chest was a little sore. I had some chest pains, and I was starting to get the chills. So it's really hot here in Seattle now. It's like 80 degrees or so, and I was getting cold. I was getting like cold. I was sweating, but I was also still cold inside. So I was using a blanket, but I was sweating. And at that point, I knew, okay, maybe I should get tested for COVID and see if I got something. So I went to get tested on Monday and just went about my day. I wasn't able to do much work because my head was still pounding, my body was still all messed up. And so I didn't do any work on Monday. Wasn't able to film any videos or do any content. I just pretty much sat on the couch and did nothing. So went about my day on Monday and just got my test. Didn't do anything, no work, anything, just watched a bunch of TV. Went to sleep pretty early. And when I woke up on Tuesday, it got even worse. So my body aches were even worse, my headache was even worse, and now my taste buds were getting kind of messed up. So I ate like a chocolate bar, and it tasted like I ate some toothpaste mixed with like ibuprofen, like some medication. So it was really weird. My taste buds, I could still taste, it was just all confused. And on Tuesday, I actually got my test back from my COVID results back, and it said positive. Now, what really sucks is my good friend's wedding is next weekend, but I should be good by then. It's 10 days from the time that you have it, which is Sunday. And I got the test back and it said I was positive for COVID or was detected. So at that point, I'm like, oh crap, I gotta go let my friends know. So I let all my friends know. There was 12 of us and pretty much all of them, we're still waiting on a couple tests, but all of them came back. Most of them were vaccinated other than one other guy. The other guy that wasn't vaccinated, he came back and he was negative, so that's good. And there's 8 other guys that tested so far that all came back negative as well. And they all spent 4 days with me there. So that was good news. But for me, my symptoms were getting worse. It started off not too bad in the morning, but got a lot worse and worse throughout the day. And then getting the test results, you know, that really sucked. And again, I wasn't able to do any work. So I was pretty much couch potatoed. I was watching a lot of Netflix and TV and wasn't able to do any work on Tuesday at all. So now Wednesday rolls around and this is the worst day by far. So I wake up, I'm pretty much paralyzed. I can't move for like an hour off the couch because my body is in such pain, like I can't even move it. My entire arms and legs and chest and even like my face was really in pain. So it felt like if I moved it, it would break off and fall off. So I just laid there on the couch for about an hour and I didn't move and I was in very severe pain. I was also drenched in sweat and I was still feeling cold, so I had to use a blanket. I was sweating my balls off and I couldn't do much. I was like that for at least half the day and couldn't move. So I was watching TV, but that was painful as well to watch TV. And I definitely couldn't do any work. And thank God I have an internet business, because if I actually had to go into a 9-to-5, I probably would have had to quit. So I was taking medication throughout the day. I don't want to talk about what medication because I don't want to get demonetized by YouTube, but I took some unconventional medication. It was talked about in the news a while ago as being a potential treatment for COVID. I'm not going to say what it is because I don't want to get kicked off this platform, but my fiance, Jackie, has lupus. And she had medication that was said to help with COVID. And so I took some of that. I took some zinc. I took some ibuprofen to help with the pain and the sore throat and all that. And I started to get better throughout like the end of the day. So by the end of the day, I was actually doing a lot better on Wednesday. Went to sleep, woke up Thursday, which is yesterday. Today is Friday now. And I was feeling so much better on Thursday. That was the first day where I got up. I was able to move around like I normally am. And I was able to go up and go to my computer and start working. So Thursday after, it was Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I was pretty much out of commission. And Thursday is the first day I was able to start working again and going back and doing my normal stuff. So I was able to get a full work day in. By the end of the day, I was starting to feel the body aches and the headaches and the chills again. So I think it was the medication that helped me the day before that carried on. And as soon as it started to wear off, that's when I started to have all the symptoms coming back. So by the end of the day on Thursday, which is last night, I was feeling pretty weak again. So I went to sleep and woke up today. And today I feel like $1 million. So I'm hoping, fingers crossed, this is done. I'm over with the symptoms. I'm not completely sure because it's still the morning here. It's 10:24 a.m. here. But what I can tell you is that COVID, it sucks, right? It's real. I didn't feel like I was gonna die at any point, but it definitely put me out of commission where I wasn't able to do much for a few days. Now, does that change my views and change and make me feel regret for not getting vaccinated? No, it doesn't, because I feel safer now. Like my chances of reinfection are on par with someone who was vaccinated because now I already have it. And I didn't feel completely confident in the vaccine because it's been less than a year and it was rushed to the market. So no, I don't regret it at all. That said, COVID, I know a few people who got COVID. It hits everybody differently. To me, it was an up and down roller coaster, right? It was, you know, bad, then good, then it was okay, then it was really bad, then it was okay, and now it's, you know, fine again. So there's some people I know that lost their taste who still don't have it back after 8 or 9 months. That would be terrible. Hopefully that's not going to happen to me. But so far, like my symptoms, the main things were major body aches. I had headache. I had chills with just sweating. I don't think I had a fever at all. I had coughing. I had some chest pains and I couldn't think at all. So it was like extreme brain fog where if I was trying to like look at a computer or read anything, it would be impossible. So that's how it affected me. I thought it would just be good to make a video about this and share with you what it was like getting COVID and how it affected my life as an entrepreneur and a business owner and what it really did to me. It really put me out of commission and made it impossible for me to do any work. So I hope that you never have to experience this, or anyone in your family or your friends. But if you did, I would love to hear your experience below, what it was like for you getting COVID. I sent out an email a couple days ago about getting it, and I got a lot of responses from both angry people that were mad that I wasn't vaccinated, and also people who had already had it, who were sharing their experience. And it was really interesting to see how different it was from person to person. So if you had COVID, would love to hear in the comments, what was it like for you? What did you experience? Was it similar to mine or different? I know it's been different for pretty much everyone I've talked to so far. So drop it in the comments. If you had COVID or you've suffered from it, let me know what it was like for you. And it's been interesting to see how different it is from person to person. But yeah, a bit of a different video for today. I thought it would be good to share, just because when I sent out that email a couple of days ago, I got quite a good response. And I wanted to just break down my experience and how it affected me. So that's it for this video. And next video, I'll get back to the actual business and financial related content. So stick around for that, and I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy.